are you?
I'm good. Thank you.
So, you're the captain of Indian women's national team and you've been playing basketball since a very long time. How did you begin or how did you start with it?
So, I started in Banaras. I used to play for my school. So, first of all, my older sister, she was studying in the class and then suddenly a PE teacher comes and, you know, he started looking for tall girls. And so, she was one of the tallest girls in her classroom. Mm-hmm. So, he picked her up, asked her to come to the court. She started playing basketball. She started playing very well. And we were the younger ones, so we used to go watch her play. Like, it is very interesting, and like, you know, we used to think like, you know, she is the superstar player and all that. We started following her. We started dribbling around the court where she used to play games and all that. So after that, Divya is my second sister. Then Prashanthi started, then I followed, then the younger one followed. So five was got into basketball. That's how we started playing basketball.
Did you face any hurdles coming forward or reaching to this position where you are today? What are the hurdles you faced, or what kind of hurdles a particular person would face if he wants to make a, or she wants to make a career in
basketball? So, I'll tell you this. Once you start playing basketball, beginning you suddenly face some problems. Like, you know, when we started, my sister started.
Mm-hmm.
We are from a small city like, you know, Banaras.
Banaras, you're from Banaras.
Yes. So Priyanka Didi started playing, and you know, she used to face certain problems. Like, you know, the thinking is such that, you know, the girl and boy playing in the same field and all that, people have obligations over it.
Mm-hmm.
So my sister started playing and then people would talk about her, like, you know, she's playing with boys and all that. But my mother was always, like, you know, she stood with us very strong, like, you know, like, I want my kids to be healthy and play, like, you know, whatever they want, they can do it. So she started playing. Priyanka Didi started, she got a lot of criticism, but then she always played well and all that.
Yeah,
so she started playing for school, then district, then nationals. And seeing her, Divya started playing, and then so Divya and Priyanka, they faced a lot of problems. But for us, at the time, we reached there because they had established their name somewhere. Like, you know, they are playing representing UP and they're playing very good and all that. So we never had such problems because we had an easy way of, like, you know, we knew that our sisters are playing well.
They were the driving force, but you being humble, saying that it was easy for you, but obviously you did your work.
Yeah, it is hard work.
Yeah.
But then the kind of struggle, apart from the game, what they had to struggle, we didn't face that. Like, you know, the kind of discrimination and the not so much support, and, you know, because girls starting anything, anywhere, it is a problem. Like, you know, they need extra support, which everybody doesn't support or provide.
So, so what happens is people play in school, or at college, they just play for out of their interest or something, they become really good at it, but then they leave it because they see that there is no future in it, or maybe, and they just pick up some company, job or something,
yeah,
and they just leave it totally.
Exactly.
So
yeah, this is, I feel, players, like, good athletes in India, if you see, ask anybody, they have become elite athletes now, but they are in sports by chance, not by choice, because nobody makes it a choice, like, you know, because there's no certain career. Like, people like to prepare for it, like, you know, like, you know, MBA, like, MBA, they want to do MBA, MBBS and engineering.
Doctor, yeah.
But then in sports, there's no certain, you can't say, like, you know, there's like, you know, you will get this job or you will become something or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
It's very dicey, like, you know, 50-50 chances. So people play for recreational stuff. There are some people who are very talented. They get into the sport and, like, you know, they play district level, state level, Indian team they play, and then they pursue their career in sports there. But as far as I can remember, I had like some 100 kids playing with me in school.
Okay.
And out of those 100, like, you know, only 12 got into the school team. And then after that, few got into district team. The few got into, like, you know, national team. And few, only I was there who was playing for Indian team. So the people who couldn't play further, they started leaving sports, like, you know, because they didn't have career after that.
Okay.
Because I played India, so I had all the options open. But then I won't discourage. But then I know that, you know, sports need more encouragement.
How did you manage both of these things? Like, you're from St. Stephen's, and you are a captain of Indian team also. So the study as well as the sports, yeah, what are they? How did you do it?
So in school, we used to play, and as I told you, my mother was always supportive of us. But then my father was into, like, too much of studies. He would tell us to study all the time. As soon as he reaches home, we'll, like, you know, we'll leave all our sports and all that. We'll sit in
the
we'll open the book
yeah.
and sit down like that because he's come home.
Okay.
So like, he would give us this strict warning saying that, you know, if you don't study well, if you don't score well, I'm not going to let you play.
Okay.
So that became our driving force. Like, you know, yeah. So that was our motivation that we have to play. If we want to play, then we have to score well in studies. So we were good at studies. And so fortunately, my older sister, like, you know, the oldest one, used to, you know, she studied, she helped her. The younger one, Divya helped Prashanti, Prashanti helped me. So that's how we helped each other in studies.
Yeah,
we had this sort of thing, like, you know, we have to, like, you know, beat everybody. We have to win finals. We have to this. So that is the motivation we get. Yeah. So I think we could manage because of, we had support of each other. And also, my mother had so much of expectations for us. She gave us the trust. So we wanted to, we never wanted to disappoint her.
No,
so we always, managed to study well and then play well. And also, I would say, like, you know, for this, we, like, normal kids, they will have a life, like, say, they'll go out for movies, they'll go out for vacations,
hangout,
and
parties,
we never did that.
Yeah.
I watched movie when I was in first year, college first year, first time.
Okay.
I never watched movie before that, like, you know, I never had chance. Think about it, I didn't have time, not chance, I had chances, my friends would ask me and all that, but I never chose to do that, because I would study, go back from school. Go to play, come back, I'll be so tired, do my homework and go to sleep. Get up early in the morning, go for conditioning sessions, come back, change, eat, and then go again school. This was the whole routine.
So, can you recall any experience of playing in India, playing at Korea, in Asian Games, or at a school, college, or anywhere which you can recall, which is like really memorable, you would like to recall it again?
So, like, say, how people ask me about the interviews, like, you know, which match is memorable and have you played against each other and all that. So, of course, when I played my first match for India, that was the best match I can recall. Like, the first match when I entered, and I knew that I'm representing my country. I have the tricolors of my jersey, and, you know, I'm representing my country. And, you know,
feeling
was proud, like, I had goosebumps everywhere. Not that I was not scared, but I was so full of proud, like, you know, that I'm representing my country.
Yes.
And, you know, I'm one of those 12 chosen men who. Like, you know, who are there, like, you know, who are just representing their country. So, yeah, I went to the court and, like, first dribble on the court, and I was, like, I was all happy. And I started playing, and that match I played really well. So, yeah, after the match, I immediately called mommy and told, like, you know, mommy, like, you know, I played the first match, and I played this, that's how I played and all that. So, that is one match I remember that's memorable.
So, over the period, I've realized that, you know, the people who are representing their country or playing at a certain level, a higher level, their studies suffer because of they can't pay so much attention or time to studies, so they can't really like, you know, pursue their studies further. And in India, if you like, you know, like, everybody knows that, you know, you have to have certificates or the degree to pursue certain, like, if you want to become a sports officer somewhere, you have to have a master's degree, you have to have a PhD degree. And so there's this post RSO, okay, or DSO. If you want to apply for that, even if you have played India for 10 years, it doesn't matter, you have to have a coaching certificate from NIS. You have to have a master's degree.
Okay.
So, what I feel, players who have played so well and so they've given 100%, you know, throughout their life, they're devoted to sports, they should be recognized and given a certain post where they can, like, you know, sit and do much better for sports. Because the kind of hard work they put in, the kind of patriotism they have in themselves, I think they will go 100%, they'll go 100% to improve sports culture and sports facilities and stuff like that.
Yeah.
I want to sit in a place where I can have the power, I can hold something where, like, you know, I can make policies, I can do much better and give my 100% in games also for the generation which are coming up. Like, you know, things which we couldn't get in the beginning or the level we played at. Why not provide them this? I can provide them this only if I'm sitting in a post where I have the power to do it.
Right.
So that's why, that's where I thought of joining as a sports officer. This is the experience I wanted to get. I worked for Basketball Federation of India also.
Mm-hmm.
I did a lot of event management for them.
And then I worked in Basketball Federation, learned a lot there. Then I left, I joined Shivnadi University.
Mm-hmm.
I did my master's and I joined Shivnadi University. And also I had this in my mind that I wanted to do sports management for a long time. But then also, in 2010, I got into level A, where level A is, you know, in India, best four players of India are in level A. So, like, me and my sisters were in level A. Where,
congratulations for that.
Thank you. So, I got into that, and I knew this is my peak time. And once this age goes, I'm not gonna, like, you know, there's a certain age where you perform at your peak level. Exactly. So, I thought, like, if I go out abroad and just for my studies, and I leave this game here right now, maybe when I come back after 2 years, I won't be the same. I won't be performing at the same level. So I decided maybe a management course I can do later, but right now I want to play for country and give my 100%. So that's how I decided to stay back, and then did my master's here only and play for country for so long. And then I joined the Chinnar University after that. And still I have plans for future. I have plans for future, saying that, you know, I want to end up in a place not only where I'm taking care of the sports in the university, but I want to take care of the sports in India in a larger scale, so that I can do really great things for coming generations in sports.
And you will definitely go under that.
Thank you so much.